video available on this, and we will find out the neighbors of India. I hope you will, you know, keenly listen and see. Wait for a minute, it will get displayed, fine? In a minute or so.
International boundaries. India shares its international boundaries with Pakistan and Afghanistan in the west and northwest. There is only a small corridor, a narrow mountain pass, that links India with Afghanistan. China and Nepal are our northern neighbors. Bhutan is in the northeast and Bangladesh in the east. The Arakan Hills separate India from Myanmar in the east. In the south are located two island nations, Sri Lanka and Maldives. They too are India's neighbors. India is surrounded by the Arabian Sea in the west and by Bay of Bengal in the east. Kanyakumari constitutes the southern tip of Indian Peninsula, the limit of India's incursion into the Indian Ocean in the south. It is located at a point of convergence of three seas, namely the Bay of Bengal, the Indian Ocean, and the Arabian Sea.
Kanyakumari jo hai yahi teen darya pe hai, yahan se Bay of Bengal hai, yahan pe Arabian Sea hai aur yahan pe Indian Ocean hai. Agar aapko kahi hai kaun si jagah hai jo teen samundron ke paas aati hai, jisko teen side mein actually pani hai, that is Kanyakumari. Yahan se this is Bay of Bengal, you will find the Arabian Sea and this is the Indian Ocean. Actually agar aap dekhenge, this is all Indian Ocean. Aur Hindustan ka jo V shape hai, isne isko divide kiya hai into the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. Actually it's all Indian Ocean. Fine, have you got it?
Yes sir.
Okay. Let us presume that this is globe. Actually it is not round, it is because of the marker, it is not writing well. You know that the line which passes through the center of the globe, we call it?
Equator.
Fine, it is known as equator. Equator divides the earth into two equal halves. Fine?
Yes, sir.
I have already told you that this is an imaginary line and yes, you will not find this line on the actual earth.
Yes.
This is an imaginary line.
Yes,
fine?
Yes, sir.
Fine. This equator divides the earth into two equal halves. This is the South Pole and this is the North Pole. And the region that lies between the equator and the North Pole, this is known as the Northern Hemisphere. This is known as the Northern Hemisphere. And the region that falls between the equator and the South Pole, this is known as the Southern Hemisphere. It's not writing. This region is known as the Southern Hemisphere. I will write SH in short. Theek hai na? This region is known as the Southern Hemisphere. The equator divides the earth into two equal halves. And India completely lies in somewhere here in the Northern Hemisphere. It completely lies in the Northern Hemisphere. There are so many latitudes which you will find on the globe. These lines are known as the latitudes. These lines are known as the latitudes. These are also known as the parallels of latitudes, because these lines are always parallel to one another. And remember one thing, when you will move from the globe towards the North Pole, these lines will go on decreasing. Similarly, when you will move from the equator towards the South Pole, these lines will also go on decreasing. So you will find that these are not of the equal length. These latitudes are not of the equal length. Their length varies. When you will move from the equator towards the North Pole, their length decreases. Inki length jo hai wo kam hoti ja rahi hai. These are all imaginary lines. These are known as the parallels of the latitude because they are parallel to one another. You will find one more set of lines on the globe. They run from north to the south, from North Pole to the South Pole. Fine? You will find such type of lines on the globe. These lines are known as longitudes. These are equal in length. These are equal in length. These lines run from the north towards the
south.
So if we talk of India, when these lines are imaginary lines.
Yes, sir.
And the longitudes and the latitudes form a grid of lines. And what these lines are meant for? I want to ask a question.
To locate a place.
These lines help us to locate a place on the globe. For example, if you know we were asked to locate the India on the globe, It will be located with the help of the latitudes and the longitudes. I will find the latitudes, the two latitudes in between the India is located. I will find the longitudes, and in this way I will come to know the location of India. These are imaginary lines. You will not find these lines on the actual earth. These lines have been drawn on the globe just to locate a place on the globe. This is what these lines are meant for. Fine?
Yes, sir.
यहां तक अभी आपको क्लियर हो चुका है?
Yes, sir.